yourself. Yeah, country love. Saying about tonight is this America, sweet America, may God that gold refined, till our success. And every game divine. And you know, when I was a little boy, I remember we always sang these words. Oh, beautiful, wild, spacious skies. Amber waves of rain, far purple mountains, majesty. Up above the fruited plain.
Wait a minute.
America, America, well, God set His grace on me. Oh, yes, He did, and He crowned that girl. Oh, don't you remember? Civil brotherhood. From my sea to shining sea.
You know, y'all can just hum a little bit longer when we get so light.
America, oh, how I love you, America. Well, my God, He not shed His grace on me. He told me he would send me brotherhood from my sea to shining sea. Yeah, Jesus, I want to thank you, Lord.
Oh, Good morning, everyone. It's good to be found in the house of the Lord again for another week. The scripture reading is a very familiar one that we should all know. I'm going to be reading 100 numbers of Psalm. All right. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name.
Amen.
That's my favorite part right here. For the Lord is good.
Yes.
I don't think y'all hear it correctly. For the Lord is good.
Yes.
I mean, y'all know that the Lord is good.
Yes.
For the Lord is good.
Yes.
His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures in all generations. May the Lord have a blessing to the reader, the hearers, and the doers of his word.
Thank you. lean on him. God is a good God. He's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. We thank you for your participation in our devotional service. It's time to turn the first service over to the musician. where he was right there. Just allowing us to be in your presence.
Amen.
Again, now, before I preach, there's some good news. We have a date. We know you've been waiting patiently. We know you're ready, and we're ready. COVID cases have gone down. Hospitalizations have gone down.
Amen.
Vaccinations have gone up. We're coming back. Coming back, we're going to be masked up. We're asking those who are at high risk to still, we're still going to be on Zoom and YouTube platforms for you. We still want to protect our elders and those that are at high risk. And so we'll be coming back. We have a date that we're going to be set to come back for our 8th and 11th services that we get back to where we used to be. I come back to eat. Amen?
Amen.
So we want God to be in the midst of it as we move forward. On this Saturday, there will be Lift, Ladies and Fellowship Together, as well as Strong Men for Christ. This Saturday at 9 a.m. This Saturday, I'm asking all of the men of the church, all of the men of the church to be here. We're going to be going over protocol for coming back. We're going to be going over where we need to be, what we need to be doing, who needs to be where, how we're going to do what we need to do. Amen. The choir coming back. Amen.
Amen.
We almost did it. Amen. We almost back. We're going to rehearse and get back. And I can't wait to have a full mass choir back in God. Wow. And so we're working hard. But once again, during the Lift and Strong Men for Christ meeting, I will be giving out details for leadership, and we have to be here. Now, some of y'all looking at me and you're not a leader, but you're going to be.
All right.
Amen?
Amen?
God is calling men and women to be leaders in the church, so you need to be here on next Saturday so that you can have full round the scope of the information that will go forward to the leader of the church, to the minister. Now, let me say this to you. This is a male-driven church. The men take lead. The men take charge. We're out front. We've been designed by God. Designed by God to lead and to protect. Amen?
Amen.
They don't send the women out front for the fight. We go. Amen. And so we have to be in place where God has placed us to be. And if we get back in our rightful places in the church, then we can take our rightful places back in the home. That's real talk right there. So I know somebody, some man out there living right now, but she won't let me. She will. But we got to get lined back up with where God wants us to be as men. And I promise you, we line up to God as men, the women will follow.
Amen.
They'll get behind, amen. And but they want a man that's gonna be following God.
Amen.
They want a God, amen. And so once again, next Saturday, leaders, men, Strong Men for Christ, Ladies and Fellowship Together, 9 a.m. Be here at the church so that you can get the details of what's going on. Now, our cap and gown graduation here at the church will be next Sunday at 8 a.m. We're asking our graduates. Is that good, John? You good? Okay. We're asking our graduates to be here at 7:30. We're asking our graduates to be here at 7:30 a.m. We're going to march in at 8:08. At 8:08, the graduates will mark in. Sister Natalie Crump is over the graduation. Marcus and Monica Roberts will be leading the graduates, leading the procession in. Amen. So we'll be there. Do we have any of our graduates here this morning? Any of our graduates here this morning? Amen.
Amen. So we got one graduate here. Amen. And so we're gonna give her a special blessing. Let's see. Ooh, I got no small bills. I'm gonna need some change back here. And that's an angel for special. That's for her being here. Amen. Graduate. Amen. Don't forget the change. We want to bless those. And so listen, let me say this before we got our graduates already signed up. If you didn't go to Harvard, then you won't be marching with the Harvard graduates. Am I right? So if you didn't go to Pilgrim Journey, you won't be marching with the Pilgrim Journey graduates. You understand what I'm saying, don't you? If you didn't work for Exxon, you won't be getting Exxon retirement. Amen? And so we want to make sure that we honor our graduates here on next Sunday in a blessed way because they've been here, they've done well, and we want to honor them. Their parents have been here, their parents have been blessed, and so we're going to do that next Sunday. I know it's going to be hard. You got to get it in. Amen? We want to do our very best. Heads are bowed, hearts are open. Father God, we just want to say thank you. We thank you, God, so much in advance for all that you've done, all that you're going to do through the word of God spoken on today. I ask, God, that you would touch each and every family represented here today in a special way. Bless them, but not just bless them, but bless them indeed. So now, God, go into the depths of your word. God, my teacher, preach the good news of the gospel. To live it out, God, up the body, through sight, to the blind. We ask you all in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. In the book of Luke the doctor, Luke the one that walked with Jesus, who needed no doctor, Luke the physician, in the book of Luke chapter 9, beginning at verse 18, constitutes the context out of which I shall take a teaching to preach the awesome and illuminating word of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ on this morning. Luke chapter 9. Luke the physician. Luke the one with the keen eye for detail. Luke chapter 9, verses 18 through 21. And when you're there, say amen. If you all would, in your private time tonight before you go to sleep, when you do your devotional, please read that whole chapter of Luke for it to give you some wonderful insight into living. Luke chapter 9, verses 18 through 20. Y'all stay with me. Keep your Bibles open. It might not be long. Amen?
Amen.
And it came to pass, if you listen, you'll get this. And it came to pass, as he was alone praying, his disciples were with him. Y'all missed it. Oh, God. I'm trying one more time. Come on. Look at your Bible. Look at your Bible. Don't look at me. Look at your Bible. Because you're going to miss it. Amen?
Yes, sir.
And it came to pass, as he was alone praying, his disciples were with him. And while he was alone, he asked them, saying, what the people say about me? And they asked, they said, some say John the Baptist, some say Elias, and others say that you're one of the old prophets who risen again. Listen. Then he said unto them while he was alone, but whom do you say that I am? Peter answered everybody, thou art Christ of God. I want to ask the question this morning. Who is he to you? You may be seated. Who is he to you? I know this is old school, but Bill Withers had a song out a long time ago, many years ago. He said, who is he? And what is he to you? And let me say this. Everybody ought to know who Jesus is. And you ought to know who he is to you. So ask the same question that the text asks. Who is Jesus to you? Do you know him? Uh-huh.
you tried it? See, if you know him and you tried him, see, some folks say he's a weightlifter. To some, he's a burden bearer, heavy load sharer. And to some, he's a lawyer in a courtroom. To some, he's a doctor that's never lost a case. My grandma was here, she said, he's the bright morning star. My mom was here, she said, he's the rose of Sharon, the lily of the valley. But who? If you ask me, I'll tell you, he's my everything. Listen, he's all I need, so he's all I want. He's everything to me. You see, mama may have, papa may have, but God bless the child that knows God. You better know who he is to you. Okay, watch this. Verse 18. It starts by saying Jesus, in the other text, it says Jesus was praying alone. You missed it. Let me go back again. Jesus was praying alone. It's in the text. He's praying alone, but his disciples are with him. Wow. Jesus praying alone, but his disciples are with him. Cataclysmic contradiction. Watch it. Jesus was praying alone. His disciples were with him. Can I unpack that box and explain it to you? How could Jesus be alone if the disciples were with him? God, listen. He was alone in prayer with the Father. He was alone with the Father in prayer. He was at one with his Lord and Savior.
Right.
Okay, watch me. There's somebody here this morning, and in the midst of all they do, you're alone. You're here physically, but you're alone in your thoughts. You're alone, and while I'm preaching everything is going to be all right. Who is he to you? Worried about a situation you can't control. You're wondering how you're going to get through this. You're alone because although your body's here with me, your mind is on the other side of town. Text says Jesus alone praying, disciples are with him. Can I say this real quick? You ought to be able to get alone, just you and Jesus, wherever you are, no matter who's around. You ought to be able to get with this you and God. You ought to be able to become one with the Father, no matter who's around or what's going on. It's amazing. Some never take the time to be alone with God. Spend much time in secret with Jesus alone by looking to him like him thou shall be. Thy friends, his color, his likeness shall see. No, I'm not what I used to be. And that's from spending time with God alone. Quiet time with God. We don't take time to pray. I mean real prayer. We got just enough time to tell him what we want. We got just enough time to tell God all we want, but we ain't got time for prayer. We ain't got time to listen. We ain't got time to hear from God. We just want to tell God all about our problems. Oh, how about this? God, how are you today? Is everything all right? God, what can I do for you today? In the army of the Lord. We just know what we know. But we don't spend time with God. We rush to everything except spending time with God. We rush everywhere but to church. Raise your hand if you got a ticket coming to church. We never got no ticket coming to church, have we? Matter of fact, they pulled you over driving too slow.
Because we ain't
rushing to church. Matter of fact, I know some, none here, they don't plan to get here till after devotion. I get there right before the last song and right before Pastor preach. They ain't trying to get here on time. But we rush to get to everything else. We rush, but we don't rush to get to spend time. Ooh, I got to get to my prayer closet, y'all. I got to go. I got to go spend time with God. I got to go tell God everything. We don't rush to do that, but we rush to do everything else. And the text says you can be alone with God and folk all around you.
Amen.
I could be sitting around a whole bunch of people sometimes, and I'll just go off into thought all by myself with God. And they'll say, hey, what you doing? And I say, just spending time with God. Mm. Just loving God, because when I think of his goodness and all that he's done for me, I could be anywhere. I could be on a cereal aisle. Thank you, Jesus. When you spend time alone, just you and God, and you begin to think about where God has brought you from, how God has kept you, and all that God has done for you, you can be alone for God around you. So stay with me. Jesus gets to pray, and then he asks the disciples, what do people say? What are they saying about me? And the answer is the same. They saying this, they saying that, and Jesus responds, but who do you say that I am? My disciple, those who've been close to me, those who have seen the many miracles firsthand, those that have walked with me, those that are close to me, what they know about me should be different from those that don't know me. But can I tell you something? And I want to make this very clear. Don't try this with your friends. Don't ask your friends what they're saying about you. Y'all got your friends, they can't wait to tell you what everybody else is saying. Child, let me tell you. I know. Be prepared. And let's say, if you really don't want to know, don't ask. Because what they really gonna tell you, when you ask what people say about you, they really gonna tell you how they feel. Come on now. If you're not prepared, don't ask. You know why I don't ask? Because I know about me. You ain't gonna tell me what nobody say about me, what nobody think about me, because I already know. And let me tell you something, I know more than you know about me. He was over here. I know. I drove there. I love to tell you what you can give, what they think about you. Nah, child, you can't tell me about me. I know more about me than anybody in here. You know about you. You ain't got to ask nobody about you. You really trying to figure out what they know. You know what you've done. And be careful, because if you allow it, folk will tell you who you are. And folk will try to define you by who they think you are. Yeah, see, okay, y'all remember a long time ago, they had this guy who was called the DC Sniper. You remember that? And the DC Sniper would hide in the bushes while people were pumping gas, and he would bust a cap at them. That's how this man came. He would shoot around, he would shoot at them, and he was killing people from a distance. And all the professional profilers and detectives, all the news media, the journalists, they all said that he had to be a redneck from Montana. And when they found out he was a Negro from Mississippi, he could have bought him with a nigga. Folk will try to define you and make you what they think you are or what they think you ought to be. You know the experts. You know, when I started preaching, all the experts, all the folk when I first started preaching, all the experts, they were saying, I knew he was going to be a preacher. I knew when he was a little boy, I knew it was something special about him. But those same experts, if I would have ended up in jail, they would say, child, we knew something wrong with him. We knew something was wrong with him. We knew he was going to end up in jail. Folk try to define you, and they always want to talk about you, and no matter how you end up, they want to tell you where you are is where you're supposed to be. But you don't know me. You didn't see nothing in me. My own mama will tell you she had no idea this mama. I told my mama I was called a priest. She said, don't you tell nobody. You're not going to go out here? No, sir. Ain't nobody calling you. Go back to sleep. She said, go back to sleep. When you wake up, you'll be normal again. Verse 20, he asked the question, but who do you say? Who am I to you? And Peter answered, he said, you are the Christ. Verse 18, he's alone with the Father praying, and then he turns to the disciples, and he says, who do they say? In theology, that's called apologetics. That's when you're trying to make sense out of your religion to other folks. And let me say this, you can't make sense of your religion to other folks because other folks have not gone through what you've gone through with Christ. Other folks don't know what he's done for you. Other folks don't know how. Other folks didn't have your experience of knowing how good God has been to you. Other folks understand why you wave hands and stand and give God glory. You can't make folks understand. They don't know like you know what the Lord has done for you. You can't make folks understand why you wake up on Sunday morning and show up for church and you give and you tithe. You can't make folk understand that. When they don't understand the principles of a loving God, when they don't understand the principles of being a part of God's blessing business, listen, you can leave church and have had the most wonderful experience in church, but you can't explain it to nobody. Because if they weren't there, when the Holy Spirit took over that place, they don't know. And let me say this, stop trying to make sense of your religion to other folks. You ain't proving to nobody. And the truth is, you can't make sense about what you believe because you don't know what you believe. As your pastor, I'm going to be honest with you, I'm going to be very transparent because transparency is a wonderful thing, isn't it? And I want to be transparent with you. I can't explain everything I believe. I can't explain how a virgin gave birth to a baby. I don't understand how Jesus walked on water. I don't understand how he multiplied fish and loaves and fed the multitude. But I do know a man from Galilee. Now, if you try to make me explain it, you might outsmart me. Some of y'all can outthink me, but I'm like my grandfather. He said, I can't tell you where it is, but I know it's in there. It's in there somewhere. Tell you, is in there somewhere. Who do you say that I am? Grandfather, he loved the Lord with all his heart. And he tell you, if you ask him, he didn't have no theology to go to. He didn't go to seminary. He didn't do none of that. But he would tell you, all I know is he feeds like a grocery man. And speaks like never. He didn't have no concordance to go to. He didn't have YouTube to go get sermons. But he knew Jesus for himself. He said he's a mother to the mothers. He's a father to the fathers. He's a bridge of a troubled water. Ooh! you know Jesus and you know who he is to you. Woo! Sit down, come on, baby. Y'all rush it. Sit down. Long over. Anybody here? Anybody here beside me? You've been alone by yourself? And you begin to just be alone, you and God, and you begin to think of the goodness of God, and you begin to think of all that he's done for you and how far he's brought you, and the tears begin to flow down your face. And somebody here said, I wasn't going to tell nobody, but I just can't keep it to myself. Verse 20. First is, who am I? Then he clears up his identity. Then he says, now, let me give you some instructions. It's in the text. He says, don't tell nobody, because you ain't ready to tell nobody. Because listen, one of the worst things you can do is run out there talking about what you don't know. Some of y'all know just enough to be dangerous. And listen, you know what the worst thing is? When you don't know that you don't know. When you don't know that you don't know, you're running to a Jehovah's Witness. They'll eat you up. Because you don't know. You ain't got your lesson. You got just enough today. And you run into that Jehovah's Witness, and next thing I know, you're selling bean pies and much time. What are you doing? Because you knew just enough, but you didn't have your lesson, and they was ready for you, and they turned you out. You ain't ready. He said, listen, don't tell nobody. Now this question, who do you say that I am is relative. The answer is based on your relationship with him. So who he is to me is different from who he is to you. Because you may have experienced some things that I didn't experience. He may have bought you out some things, delivered you from some stuff that I hadn't experienced. So to you, he's one thing, but to me, he's another. Listen. You can ask two people the same question. Ask them. Don't do it. But just ask them. Say, how's Pastor Simpson? Is he pretty good? Now, the one that I've done some things for, the ones that have been blessed through my ministry, the ones whom I've helped through my teaching, they'll say, ooh, he's an awesome man of God.
Amen.
He's a great speaker, sound teacher, wonderful counsel, wonderful leader. That's the one who's been blessed by my ministry. But if you ask the ones that I had to say no to, you ask the ones I had to reprimand, you ask some of the deacons that had to leave because they were reprimanded and they didn't like it, you ask the ones that I didn't make it to the hospital to see, you ask the ones that I didn't make it to the graduation, because all the graduation on the same day. You don't care the same day. Plus it's raining. You ask them, and they gonna say, child, please, he ain't about nothing. Can't preach his way out of paper bag, child. And that's how it is. Who I am to you depends on your experience with me. You catch first light on a good day? Child, you're the best man I ever had. Catch on a bad day? Negro, please. And he's supposed to be a preacher. Child, please.
Been so good to some people that don't recognize who he is or that it's him that's been good to him. That's the same thing when you don't know it, that you don't know how good God has been to you.
Woo! See the Raymond Ride out, he's a hero.
Yeah, to some who've lost love on Sister Kim, he's a way maker. He's a friend that's sticking closer than a brother, y'all. But if you're like me, Jesus is everything to me. Jesus is all the world to me. Some people want houses and land, but just give me Jesus. You've got to know him for yourself. You've got to know who he is to you. See, if you know him for yourself, you ought to praise him. If you know who Jesus is, if he's been good to you, if you know who he is, if you know that he's been there for you, if you know he's been there in my time of trouble, if you know who God is, you ought to stand on your feet. Give God some glory and say, God, I thank you for who you are.
Some of y'all, you have these wonderful names. You call him Wonderful Counselor, but to me, I just call him Andy. That's what I call him, Andy. And he walks with me. And he talks with me. And he tells me that I'm his own. And the joy we share as we carry them is like none.
I ain't always been like this. Matter of fact, you remind me of me. And look at what God has done for me. When you begin to tell them, he's done it for others, he'll do the same. When you begin to tell him, he did the same, he'll do the same for you. You got to tell him that you are a low down, dirty wretch too. You got to be able to tell him. Tell him, I'm not perfect. Tell him. Take it. I still cuss every now and then. You got to tell them. Because they understand realness. And when you're real, you'll draw people to you. I tell everybody, and I tell you today, if you're looking for a perfect church, this ain't the place. No, child. The church was perfect till we walked in. Then here y'all come, messing everything up. Come on, listen. Remain standing all over the building. Going over doors of the church. Listen, if you're here, deacons are coming. If you're here, you've never accepted Christ Jesus as a person. If you're here, you have a church home, place that you can call your own. We offer you Christ. We offer you Christ today. The deacons are coming. The chairs are coming. So if you're here, we offer you Christ. And this is all you got to do. Come down from wherever you are. Tell the person next to you, excuse me, I'm going to join the body of Christ today. So if you're here, while the song is being sung, stand, step, come down from your mouth, as hard as your heart. When you hear God's word, the doors of church are now open.
Broken. Strength when I'm weak.
teenage daughters. I'm gonna send them back with our youth pastor and first lady of the youth pastor. Don't go back with them to my office. They shine. Give them a hand since they shine. Amen. We'll go back to my office, bunch of mom and dad, get them. We wanna bring them into the church. And they in the youth department now, mind. They in the youth department, amen. Father, won't you stand? Would you introduce us to your wife and your oldest daughter?
Yes, good morning, everybody. Thank you for accepting me today. This is my lovely wife, Alicia Keith, my daughter, Ariana, and my daughter, too, is Camille and Abigail.
Listen, before I ask the Father to give a statement, I want you to know also, this is a male-driven church. We want fathers in place leading their families.
Amen.
And so we thank God that you led your family to become a part of this church. And so now, we are family.
Right.
Amen. Amen. And so at this time, we all would like to make a statement to the church that we're going to give you the right hand of fellowship.
Well, I've been coming out here for, actually probably a couple of years. Years already, and I just love it. I mean, you guys have welcomed me all of these scenarios, COVID-19, we've gone through it. I keep in touch with Pastor Simpson, and I just like the love, how much y'all appreciate and love each other here, as well as God at the same time. And I believe this is the right church for me. Not that I believe, I know it's the right church.
Hey, thank you for allowing us to be part of your family. I'm not going to talk too much about it and then cry, but thank you so much.
Now, let me tell you, this one right here, we got history. So I have to go twice a year to get well man checkup, you know. And every time I go, they say, well, we want to draw your blood to make sure everything's okay. And guess who we back there drawing the blood? This one right here. And so I'm gonna go, you know, when it comes to needles and stuff, so this one right here. I said, no, I want her. I want nobody else to draw blood, just her. And so I have to look the other way, and I said, what this one time? I said, will you sing to me? Will you sing to me while you draw my blood? She said, Jesus loves you. And so we got to meet like that, and so God has been really good to me. And it just goes to show, you never know who. Who you're around. You never know who's going to be in a certain place and a position for you. Because had it not been for her, I wouldn't have got my blood drawn. I just said, nah, I'm good. Because you know, you can tell that I'm good. But with her, so God is awesome. And he leads us. He guides us in certain ways. He moves within us and our being. And a lot of y'all today, you don't know how you got here. But one day God ordered your steps. He showed up. And you've been here ever since. Isn't that story just right here? This right here. This is a good story right here. H-E-B, I was behind in line. Remember Chanel? I was behind in line. And so I got to talking to her. And she looked at me and said, won't you just leave me alone? She didn't want me bothered. And I told her, and we got to talking some more until I was passing the church. And she started coming and has been coming ever since. How many years? 4 years. And we love you. And so we thank God for you. We never know how God brings us, how God orders us, how God keeps us. And he's keeping us for a certain moment in time so that we could be in a certain place to do a certain thing. So if you're here, God has a purpose for your life. It's not just to be in church. It's not just to come hear the word of God. But there's a purpose over your life.
has a purpose for your life and the life of your family here at this church. And I want to give you a word today. Jeremiah says everything will be all right. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your understanding, all your passion. He's going to order that. He's going to do miraculous things in your life. And all you got to do is prepare and wait on. So as your pastor, offer you right here in the fellowship. Welcome you to the Pilgrim Journey Baptist Church, which is now your church. Like Sister Slade would say, we are family. Amen. So if you're going to go with Sister Garvey, she's going to take you guys, get you guys set up for orientation. The youth pastor, they got your kids coming. We got them. Amen. Y'all come on, give God a hand of glory. Give God a hand of praise. What a blessing. What a blessing. Addison Church daily. Now, do we have any visitors? Anybody visiting with us here this morning? Any visitors? Amen. If you've been visiting, would you stand? Visitors, would you stand? Amen. Want to let you? Amen. Let me say this. We all thank God for this light and all we take them for granted. We thank God for your presence here. We'll allow you to have a word at this time. Yes, sir.
I'm just glad to be in the house of the Lord. I have a PK. So I'm a preacher's kid and a pastor's kid. My father passed about 10 years ago on Father's Day. But then my father-in-law passed on Father's Day about 6 years ago. So we from Fort Worth, Texas. Our membership is a couple of First Missionary Baptist Church in Fort Worth, Texas. We're glad to be here. We had not strength and been here before.
Yes, sir.
And every time we come, we enjoy it.
Amen.
Anywhere that anybody is serving God, you talk about experience. I have a multitude of experience with God.
Yes, sir.
And I know
yes, sir.
Where my blessings come.
Bless you. I was about to say, we really do enjoy the show. I'm here today to visit my uncle, James Davis. It's my uncle. And so we come to from a morning day. I'm going to take you to come and see him. But we always enjoy when we come. And y'all pray for us.
Amen. Yes, sir. Coming your way.
Yes, sir.
Good morning, Saints. My name is Pastor Larry Traylor.
Amen.
And I'm visiting today because my family that just went out asked me to come. And I thank God for that. I thank God for that kind of thing. Amen. But I know it.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. And I'm just glad to be here today. I like the spirit of the Lord in this place. And God has been good to me. Very good. Because I'm alive today. I should have been there. Hallelujah. But God has a purpose for my life. Amen. I know He has it. That's why I stick around people that got purposes. You be around people that ain't got no purpose, you're going to lose your purpose. You know, I praise God for that today. I'm glad I came to you. Amen. This is what I need. Sometimes we don't know what we need. Or we don't know what we need to be. But like you said, when God order your steps, when He order your steps, you might not know where you're going. Amen. But He knows. You might not know what you're looking for, but God knows. Amen. I thank God for the message today. Very good message. And I thank you all for allowing me this time. God bless you.
In your private time, in your thoughts, as you go at home tonight, read that passage. If you don't know who God is to you, you need to know it for yourself. If you don't know Him like you should, intimately, ask yourself, who is He to me? And I promise you, you go down that faith file of all God has done, how He's been there every step of the way, trials, trouble, tribulation, how He's been there. It's a blessing. Okay, a couple of reminders. Number one, first reminder is, this Saturday,
our meeting. It's going to be Strawman Price Lift Leadership Meeting Together. Please come out and share. You don't have to be a member. You don't have to do nothing. You just show up and get the marching orders, and the church goes out, and then we do what the church is supposed to do. So that's this Saturday, 9 a.m. Leaders are coming together. Men are coming together. The women are coming together so that we can prepare to be back in the church and be doing what God wants to do. Be the church that God would have us to be. Secondly, next Sunday is the graduation. Teachers and former teachers, you will be marching in the procession behind Pastor Robertson and his wife. You'll be marching in. So teachers, if you're professionals in the education, you get with them. You should be here 7:30 also, helping them get the kids together and be prepared to march in. Teachers, if you work in the school district, if you work for the district as a teacher, as anybody that helps these children to get to school, well, no matter what your job is within the education arena, we need you here marching in with Marcus and Monica in the processional, bringing these kids in. It takes a village to raise a child.
Amen.
It's not just the teachers. It's the people. It's the people that feed them in the cafeteria. Everybody is important and plays a role. So we want all of you to come in, march in, so that we can support our children on next Sunday. Firstly, did I leave anything out? Did you want to stand and tell everybody who I am to you? Tell who? Did you? What am I? No, not today. She said, not today. Today's not a good day. Next week. Amen. Listen, we're about to leave this place with Memphis. Coach Deacon Webster will be in the back with the baskets. You can give your love offerings. You can give your tithes and offerings. You can give that on the way out. It has been a good day. It's been an awesome day. It has been a wonderful day. God has been so good. So won't you stand all over this place? Prepare to leave this place, but never His presence. Amen. Go ye now, and know that God is good. Go ye now, and know that God will take care. Go ye now on the wings of His unmitigated love. Go ye now and tell others of a risen, resurrected, one day returning Savior. Go ye now, and know who God is to you. Go ye now. And now, may the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide henceforth, now and forever. And the people of God said, amen. Amen. Bless you. Thank you.
in liberating strife. Who more than self? Their country love. Saying about tonight is this America, sweet America, may God thy gold refine. Till our success. Nobleness and every gain divine. And you know, when I was a little boy, I remember we always sang these words. Oh, beautiful, wow, spacious skies. Amber waves of grain, far purple mountains, above the fruity plain.
Wait a minute.
America, America, well, God set his grace on thee. Oh, yes, he did, and he called that good. Well, don't you remember, said it, brotherhood. From sea to shining sea. You know, y'all can just hum a little bit longer when it's all right. America, oh, how I love you, America. Well, my God, he not shed his grace on me. He told me would, should be brotherhood.